in a typical remodel of a home, which will generally happen a few times in a home's life, and with this house being around 100 years old, there's a lot of materials and wood that gets thrown away and put in a dumpster. And with this particular house, we're only throwing away the drywall and the concrete, which absolutely cannot be used again. But whatever it takes to save more wood and get it back into the world. I like to say the stuff is threecycled instead of recycled, because it was first a tree, and then it was a home, and then afterwards it'll be art. I had been laid off a couple times trying to get media jobs in New Orleans. I'd gotten laid off. The last time it happened, I was like, well, I got to do something. I had just renovated my floors in my house and was very excited and intrigued with working with the flooring, with the wood on the floors, which is heart pine. And I just loved the smell of it. I liked the way the stain reacted with the wood, the different colors you could get with stain, the way it penetrated, the way you could use tape to prevent it from penetrating in places. And it was all just very beautiful to me. If this is how one person can take trash and convert it into something beautiful, then what could systems do if they were put in place? What could society do if it was motivated in that direction? What could corporations do? What could governments do? Is unlike anything they've seen before. It's not trying to be something else. It can be this, the sword through which I will be heard, or this, the expression through which I'll be heard. This is a piece called Ashes to Ashes. It's about death coming up from life. So it's got a dual sort of purpose. Here we have like the worms and the decaying matter in the soil giving birth to life. And of course the universe is up here neither hostile nor benign, just indifferent, as Carl Sagan used to say.